Well, once again, good afternoon. How are you all doing today? Wow. You guys are more tired than our students, Bethany. We just went through a full day of working out and exercising. How are you all doing today? Much better. Good afternoon. Welcome to the John Wayne Middle School here in Bedford, Massachusetts. Who is here for the very first time witnessing a black belt graduation? Raise your hands. A little bit higher. Raise them a little bit higher. Those of you who have been here before, give them a round of applause and thank you for coming and joining us today. They're about to experience something that they've probably never seen before, or at least we hope. My name is Peter Foti. It's a pleasure and an honor once again to be back and hosting this event. It's a privilege to be a black belt at Kalyan's Karate School of Kempo Karate. Martial arts, a very important part of my life, very important part of my self-discipline, and has meant and done a lot for me and my family over the years. My two sons have been through the school as well, and we've all benefited from it in many ways. So many different elements go into martial arts. A lot of people look at it as the physical aspect only, but there's so much more. There's a mental and emotional aspects as well. So with physical, to be working on your health and staying healthy and, you know, burning off those calories and learning good self-disciplines about taking care of yourself, eating right, talking about the things that we do. The mental aspect, the self-discipline, focusing on things in your life that are important, taking care of your family, your schoolwork, your business for us adults and teens who are in the course as well. And of course, there's the emotional aspect. Lots of encouragement in a situation like this. And I think that it's through that encouragement and through the family atmosphere, specifically here at Kalyan's Karate Studio, that I see a lot of growth and development in all the students, no matter what age they are. So they've put in a long day already. For those of you who are not aware, for those of you who are here for the first time, you may have heard things about it. These students, every one of them, there's 52 today graduating from one degree belt to another, started at 8 o'clock this morning at the high school field just behind us, running 2, 4, and 5 miles to earn their belts. And you may say, well, that was a few hours ago, they've rested since. No. They go directly from running that 2 miles or 4 miles to the karate studio where they have to do a series of push-ups, a series of kicks, and other forms of getting their body in shape, the physical aspect. They do have to do some sparring with their self-defense techniques as well. And so their bodies have been beaten up quite a bit today. The juniors get a little bit of a rest after a while, but the seniors, the teens and adults keep going right up almost till the graduation time. So these folks have been really putting their body through a lot. So what I'm going to ask you folks to do is when they come out here as a group and as they perform individually their self-defense techniques and their forms, that we show appreciation for the hard work that they've done today and all the hard work that they've done to get here. This is a great accomplishment for so many of us. When we start off in a situation like this, we don't know what we're getting ourselves in, or if we've seen our siblings or our parents doing it, we try something new. But when you start working at it, you start feeling proud of yourself, you start seeing the things you can do in life because of your effort and your ongoing spirit of doing more and more and learning more and more, there's a sense of self-pride that's good for your self-esteem and builds you up. So we've got a great bunch of people back here who are ready to come out here and show you what they've done to earn their next degree or their first degree black belts. So we're going to open the curtains in just a second. We're going to start off then with you folks. Let's raise the roof just a little, making some serious noise for them. This is the November 2015 graduating class of Kalyan's Kempo Karate School.
saved that last one. Good.
We need everyone to think about half a step back.
Good.
Just sit right down, comfortable, listen to your name.
Student Freeze, have you heard some of the words there? That help us focus and remember who we are as people within ourselves and dealing with one another. Developing ourselves in healthy manners, just that reminder. Treating others with respect. No self, you know, so much built up yourself that you're going to put others down and feel better than anyone else. So it's a great thing to have some student creeds just to basically give you an outline of what it is that these students are learning more and more each day in their lives and how they use those things to control themselves. So we're going to start with our self-defense techniques and our forms. Each student's going to come up and perform either a group of self-defense techniques. They're going to show you what they've learned on their techniques and how to defend themselves. Or they may come up and use a form, which is going to show you how they learn self-discipline in terms of handling their body, muscle memory, and whatnot. And a few are using weapons today, too, which is pretty exciting. So they're going to come up and do those things individually based on their own strengths of what they can do so well to show you how they've gotten here today. We're going to start off with our demonstrations with our students who are earning their first degree junior black belt. So first up, I need Jameson Baird.
Thank you.
An extra round of applause for our resident newbie, Mr. Cummins. Naomi Miller.
Thank you.
right, Dennis Jalako. Some of you that are here for the first time may not recognize these young ones. They may have seemed shy to you in the past. That's one of the things that's great about martial arts when you start getting involved to such a great degree that you get some entertainment and enjoyment out of it, that you're able to beat up your instructors. And can I just cut up? Thank you. And have some fun with it. These kids have grown so much. And just when I think they can't get any smaller, we've got these young ones coming up and doing a phenomenal job. So give those that group a round of applause one more time. These students have been here before, and they're coming up with their second degree junior black belt. So we're going to start off this group with Jack Brenner.
Woo! Let's go, Jack! Let's go!
Michael.
Come on, Michael.
Hey!
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 Sophia Mando.
Nine! Nine! Nine!
every single one in that group. Let's move on. Those earning the third degree, junior black belt. We'll start with Brianna Attardo. Meaning. There's blocking, there's punching, there's defending yourself, and stuff like that. So similar to dance, there's that muscle, self-discipline, and such. Now we're going to move on to our teams and adults. Let's give that last group a round of applause. Going for their first degree full black belt, we're going to start with Jason Genova.
Let's go, Jason.
Isabella Kenyotu.
Hi! 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 We say that we did our best. For the rest of my life, I will keep that black belt attitude.
Next up, we have Naomi Miller.
During my karate training, I have learned many lessons in karate that I will continue to apply throughout my entire life. All of these lessons impact other people as well as myself. One thing I have learned is perseverance, to never give up. I have learned perseverance by coming to karate class for 5 years, even when I was tired or busy with other things. I have learned to keep going, even when things get hard, and I will apply this to all my other activities, such as my violin lessons, fencing, soccer, and schoolwork. Another skill I've learned is self-discipline. Self-discipline is doing things yourself without being told over and over by others. I use self-discipline to get my schoolwork and other chores done before I take time to do fun activities. A third thing I've learned is that respect is extremely important. The number one rule into karate is to be respectful of everyone around you. I'll continue to be respectful of others, which will help me go further in life. If you respect others, they will usually respect you back. It's going to be a goal in my life to continue to treat other people with respect. The last main skill I've learned from karate is self-control. Learning karate gives you a powerful weapon. And self-control is absolutely necessary when having an ability like this. All martial artists should be afraid of hurting people. If I were in a tough situation, I need self-control so I don't go too far. Karate is about self-defense and discipline, not trying to hurt people. Every single one of these skills, perseverance, self-discipline, respect, and self-control, are things I've learned throughout my karate training. All of these things are important to having a successful life and be the best person I can be.
I want a copy of this one. Very nice of you. Let's welcome up Christopher Cox with our next essay.
Self-discipline, and respect for others. In karate, I've developed confidence in myself. For example, of this is being able to approach strangers and start conversations at school, grocery stores, and while playing soccer. Another example of how I've learned confidence is being able to perform in front of crowds. My favorite example of this is the time that Mr. Callahan asked for volunteers to demonstrate to the leadership team how to tie a bell. I have confidence in myself to put my hand up and volunteer. Other examples of confidence is not being afraid to try new things, such as new foods, trying gymnastics at American Ninja Warrior Camp, and being able to read a report in front of my class at school. In karate, I've also learned self-discipline. For example, being able to do homework and soccer practice while I'd rather be doing some other things. Finally, karate has taught me to have respect for others, such as saying sir and name. An example of this was the time when I was in the grocery store waiting in line for the cashier. The lady in front of us let us cut in front of her, and I responded by thank you, ma'am. The lady and the cashier were very impressed that a child my age had such good manners. As I get older, I will continue to have confidence, self-discipline, and respect for others. By practicing these karate lessons, I'll have a more positive life and people see me as a good person.
Our adult team group, Jason Genova.
Everything that I have learned throughout my karate training has made me a better person. The first time I walked into the studio, I was really intimidated, but over time, I began to find that everyone there was incredibly nice and helpful. After seeing all of these nice people, I began to think that the improvement of my karate skills also depends on the improvement of my attitude and self-discipline. Over my time of being at the school, I began to see the usefulness of each word of the month and realized that they could actually make more of a difference than talking about it in the last couple minutes of class. Because of this, I became more patient, caring, and thankful over the years. I developed lifelong relationships with friends that I never would have met if I hadn't been into the studio and hadn't helped me overcome my shyness. And that's just one of the many ways as to how this program has shaped my life. After seeing everyone say, "Goodbye, sir, goodbye, ma'am," and did my best, and the constant, "Thank you, sir, ma'am," I actually feel morally obligated to say these things to people and thank them for even the most insignificant of deeds. All this also runs side by side with how I have also learned karate and currently testing for my black belt. I appreciate everything that this studio has done for me and find it to be one of the best things that I have ever done with my life. So, thank you.
You've all seen what's been going on up here. And this side of the room has seen one perspective, and this side of the room has seen one perspective, and you all have seen one perspective. You just heard four different perspectives with the same overlapping theme of being positive in life, being moving forward, wonderful things you can get out of creating yourself through learning through martial arts and such, especially in a program like this. These people have worked hard, they've come a long way, starting from a white belt, being nervous in your first class, going through the ranks. A lot of perseverance, definitely, to get to this point in their lives. So we're about to give the awards of their black belts and their stripes at this time. So we're going to ask our students to please rise. Junior black belts, those going for their third degree junior black belts, have two red stripes on their black belts already. So today they're getting their third stripe that advances them and puts them closer to their first degree black belt in the near future. So we're going to start in that order, going to second degree black belts for the juniors, and then we'll go to the brand new belts for the first degree junior black belts and the teen adults at the end. So, our junior third-degree black belt recipients are Brianna Attardo, Alexandros Fritsakis, Simon Padavid, Daniel Jaffe, Alex Lynn, John McCullough, Leon's looking at me like, don't forget me. Leon Zeltzer, moving into their second degree junior black belt, Jack Brenner, Liam Buckley, Liam Carson, Sophie Cohen, Isabel Jaffe, Michael Lindo. Sophia Lindo. Jessica Lynn. Michael Patterson. Tori Postler. Tyler Rausch. Dariah Reichwitz. Sebastian Revez. Catherine Richardson. Reed Sutter. Jack Thomas. And Sarah Worth. Miss anybody? Ladies and gentlemen, your first degree junior black belt recipients. Jameson Baer. Peter Benson. Christopher Cox. Nicholas Del Sobra.
Thank you, sir.
Will Del Sobra. Devin Pasha. Christopher Lando. Aria Maher. Naomi Miller. Gianna Massidi. Matthew O'Connor. Sophia Paniotu. Mira Patel. Joseph Patterson. Aditya Rao. Carter Rausch. Scott Schickler. And Dennis Gioiacco. Any extra belts there on the table? Our recipients of our adult team first degree full black belts. Jason Genova. Isabella Pinyotu. Cole Parks. Christina Walensky. Steven Zukowski. We're not done yet, but one huge round of applause to the graduating class. What we're going to do next. We're going to bring our first degree recipients, both the junior first degree and the adult team super first degree black belt recipients up front for belt tying ceremony as we wrap up the afternoon. I'm going to hand the microphone over to Mr. Callahan.
Okay, guys, let's have everybody kneel down on your knees. And just put the black belt on your right side. So it's going from front to back. And untie your old belt. Fold it up nice and neat. Actually, I'm sorry, put the black belt in front of you, side to side, and put the brown belt on the right side. Otherwise, you're going to be brown belts again. I'm going to make the letter L with the two belts. Brown belt and the junior black belt will be on your right side. Black belt will be out in front of your knees. Get it best you can. The two belts together will form the shape of an L. And before we tie our black belt on this tradition, we like to talk about the four L's. The first L is longevity. Right? The goal is, when we train in the martial arts, to lead a really, really healthy lifestyle, take good care of our bodies, and make it a goal to live to be at least 100 years old. And we also have our self-defense skills that, you know, hopefully we never have to fight, but they, you know, may be able to save us someday. Okay? Second L we like to talk about is the word loyalty. It's really, really, really important. And we remember black belts and karate students were very, very loyal. Our family always comes first. It's so, so important. People can count on us. If we say we're going to do something, we do it. We're extremely loyal. The third L we like to touch base on is the word lie. And what that is, it's a reminder that even though we may only wear a black belt, be dressed in our gi for a few hours a week when we're training, we're a black belt 24/7. There's a saying, once a black belt, always a black belt. This is a certain behavior that's expected from us at all times, okay? So we can be a great student and respectful and working hard and disciplined when we're training on the mat, and then be somebody else maybe at home. Maybe we're a little messy or sloppy, or we don't live up to our expectations, or at school, So it's really important that once a black belt, always a black belt. And it doesn't mean we're perfect, but we do our best wherever we are. We have a certain code, a certain behavior we live up to. Okay, and the last level, the fourth level I'd like to talk to, is lots and lots. What that means is just because you earned your junior black belt or first degree black belt, you still have a lot to learn. Okay, and that means that you don't know everything. So how many of you guys do this when mom or dad are talking, you say, I know, I know, I know. Who does that? All right, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret you don't know, okay? So you have two ears and one mouth for a reason, all right? Does anybody know why? Listen more and talk less, okay? So you have a lot to learn. You don't know everything, none of us do. So with that, we're gonna have you guys just lean forward and touch your forehead down onto the new belt. Right there for a second. This is the part where we transfer all the knowledge and the many, many hours of training and the kicking and screaming at times. I don't feel like going to class, okay? It all goes into the new belt. Bumps, lumps, bruises, everything is in the new belt. Good, we'll have you sit right back up. Take a second, tie that new belt on. And I must warn you, these new belts are uncooperative. It's like trying to tie a 2x4 around your waist. So while you're tying your belts on, I'll tell you another tradition. Is that tonight, when you go to bed, you want to sleep with your black belt on. Okay, that's very, very important. This is an old tradition we have in our school. If you don't, when you wake up tomorrow, it will be a white belt again. Okay, so I'll be a little more specific. You don't have to go to bed with a stinky gi on, okay? You can get cleaned up and wear your pajamas, but sleep with your black belt on tonight. All right, just an old tradition we have, just to break it in, make it real. You can wear your belt knots in the center district today. Christopher, that is the best first belt knot I've ever seen. Nice job. Shouldn't look like a square knot when you're done, guys. Everybody jump right up in a good rest stance. Good. A couple of things here. Now that you guys have earned junior black belt, you'll come to the black belt class next week. And in order to participate in the black belt class, you're going to need some commas. And we just happen to have some. Guys, we tape them together. Mr. Clemens taped them together for a reason. Keep them that way, all right? Show up to class with them taped. Don't take them apart, because we're going to show you how to use them. Even though they're not sharp, still a weapon, so keep them together until you come to class next week. Parents, they're not sharp, not to worry. You guys in the back, we've always given out the katana. A katana for you guys. Again, parents, we order without the edge on them, so they're not sharp. You bring that to class next week. If you come to the black belt class on Thursday night, Mr. Clements will teach you a really cool set and learn how to do some moves with the katana. Okay? Cool. You guys in the back, why don't you just come forward a little bit? Good rest dance. We also have certificates for you guys. Make sure you do not leave without your certificates. Mrs. Callahan has those. Also, make sure you have your brown belts. Okay, and the last thing I want to say is, again, you guys have been crying for a long, long time. That means mom and dad have been driving you to class 2 to 3 times a week. They've been paying for it, very, very expensive. When you guys are done, make sure you give them the biggest hug you possibly can. Say thank you. You want to show an attitude of gratitude, okay? So what I need from you guys, real quick, every single good rest dance, the best of your ability. I know you guys have your swords and the compass and everything. I want a student Creed 4 so loud, all right, that it shakes the whole building. You guys ready? Student Creed 4, go ahead, go. belt. You guys, Mike, come on up on the stage. Come on up, everybody. Come on up. Guys, Mike, your parents, give them a hug. You got some certificates. Come on up, guys. Come up here if you want. Take some pictures. Great job, guys.
Thank you. let's go, because Quinn, we'll go without you.
Ah! Here you go!